I would like to introduce and welcome Professor Hawking and Lucy. Thank you all so much.
Why should we go into space? What is the justification for spending all that effort and money on getting a few lumps of moon rock? Aren't there better causes here on Earth? We thought space was worth a big effort in the 60s. In 1962, President Kennedy permitted the U.S. to landing a man on the moon by the end of the decade. This was achieved just in time by the Apollo 11 mission in 1969. The space race helped to create a fascination with science and led to great advances in technology, including the first large-scale integrated circuits, which are the basis of all modern computers. A new interest in space would also increase the public standing of science generally. The low esteem in which science and scientists are held is having serious consequences. We live in a society that is increasingly governed by science and technology, yet fewer and fewer young people want to go into science.
Professor Stephen Hawking is arguably our greatest living cosmologist. Struck down in his 20s by a progressive motor neuron disease, he is entirely paralyzed and can only communicate using a speech synthesizer. But when Professor Hawking speaks, NASA listens.
I fear for our future. Our planet, Earth, is threatened with an ever-expanding population and only finite resources. We need a plan B. If our species is to survive the next 100 years, let alone 1,000, it is imperative we voyage out into the blackness of space to colonize new worlds across the cosmos. The ISS is pioneering space exploration. Without this knowledge, travel into deep space is impossible. Within 50 years, I have no doubt, there will be settlements on the moon, and by the end of the century, I truly hope, humans will be living on Mars. I think the work on the ISS will take a new generation of human space explorers out into our solar system and beyond. I would like to congratulate the New Horizons team and NASA on their pioneering, decade-long mission to explore the Pluto system and the Kuiper Belt. Billions of miles from Earth, this little robotic spacecraft will show us the first glimpse of mysterious Pluto, the distant icy world on the very edge of our solar system. It is 50 years since the first successful mission to Mars, Mariner 4, sent back 21 images of the red planet. Now the solar system will be further opened up to us, revealing the secrets of distant Pluto. The revelations of New Horizons may help us to understand better how our solar system was formed. We explore because we are human, and we want to know. I hope that Pluto will help us on that journey. I will be watching closely, and I hope you will too.